Now, today we are going to learn what is relation and mapping. What is relation and mapping? Relation. Definition of relation was in your class 11 syllabus. This says that if A and B be two non-empty set. Now see, these are two non-empty sets. So relation is defined only in between non-empty sets. Two non-empty sets. Then any subset of A cross B is called a relation from set A to set B. A relation from set A to set B. So this is nothing but, relation is nothing but subset of A cross B. Now we know that if n a is equal to x1 and n b is equal to x2, then n of a cross b is equal to kato x1 x2. Since n of a cross b is x1 x2, so power set of a cross b has number of elements 2 to the power x1, x2. So that proves that there are 2 to the power x1, x2 number of subsets of A cross B. So A cross B has this number of subsets. For example, if NA be 2, if NB be 3, this is our 6, this is our 2 to the power 6, that is 64. So if A contains two elements and B contains three elements, we can define 64 relations, 64 different type of relations from A to B as well as B to A. That we have learned in class 11. Now we are taking some examples. Now we will discuss the matter with some examples. In our today's class, we will just revise the 11 syllabus. The contents in with what was in your 11th class, today I will just discuss this. For example, let A is equal to P, Q and R, and B is 1, 5, 7 and 9. So P has 3 elements, Q has 4 elements, so A cross B has 3 into 4, 12 elements. So you can define 2 to the power 12. So A cross B has 12. Hence we can define 2 to the power 12 different relations from A to B or B to A. So this is our first sum. Now what is A cross B? A cross B is ordered pair P, 1, P, 5, P, 7, P, 9, baki gulo nijera likhe pari. Now write the remaining. I have written 4 and there are 12. You write down the remaining 8. If I ask you to give me any subset of this, And relations are denoted by R1, R2 and this, like this. So now you provide me any subset of this. Now which elements to consider? Which elements to consider? Say I take P1, I take Q5, Q7 and R9. I may take R2, P1, P9, Q7. Now see, we have already told that we can define 2 to the power 12 number of relations from A to B. That is 4096 number of relations we can define. These two are two of those 4096 relations. So there are plenty of relations left for you to write. You don't need to write the remaining 4094. Just one or two examples is enough. Now see, these are two relations from A to B. Now we will discuss about two important things. First is domain of a relation. First is domain of a relation. What is domain of a relation? Domain of a relation R is the set of elements in A which has an image under R. What does it mean? Let this be R. Now domain of R1. Domain of R1 is equal to members of A, since it is relations from A to B, we are taking members of A. If it is relation from B to A, we will take members of B. Members of A which has image under R1. Now see, P has image. Now see, P1, this is called image, this is called pre-image. One is image of P and P is pre-image of 1. Q is pre-image of 5 and 5 is image of Q. Now, Q is pre-image of 7 and 7 is image of Q. R is pre-image of 9 and 9 is image of R. So now see, under R1, is P has an image? Yes, P has an image. So domain of R1 contains P. Now see Q. Is Q has an image under R1? Yes, Q has multiple images. One image is enough to enter here. So Q. Similarly, R also has an image. So domain of R1 is this. In this case, look at, this is equal to A. But if we consider this R2, now see domain of R2. Under R2, P has an image. P has an image. Multiple image. 1 and 9 are image of P. Q has an image. But see, R has no image under R2. R has no image under R2. So domain of R will not contain. Domain of R2 will not contain this element R. This is called domain that you learn in class 11. Next, After domain, it comes range. Now comes range. What is range? Range of R is equal to set of elements of B which has a pre-image under R. Which has a pre-image under R. R is under a pre-image achi. Clear? Bujhte pachho?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now see, from this R1, range of R1, this R1 is equal to, now we have to find elements of B which has pre-image under A. Now see whether there is any pre-image of 1. Yes, 1 is a pre-image P. So 1 will be there. Does 5 has a pre-image? Yes, 5 has a pre-image. So five will be there. Does 7 has a pre-image? Yes, 7 has a pre-image. Does 9 has a pre-image? Yes, 9 has a pre-image. So 9. Now see, in this case, this is B. But for this range, now see, 1 has a pre-image, so 1 is there. 5 does not has any pre-image, so 5 will not be there. 7, yes, 7 has a pre-image and 9 has a pre-image. Simply, we can say that domain is nothing but set of the first elements of the ordered pairs. Set of the first element of the ordered pair. These are called ordered pair. Chromo jugmo. Ordered pair. So first elements. You see, the first elements are P, Q, Q, and R. That is P, Q, R. Q has to arrive two times, so you don't need to take two Qs. Generally, it's only one time. And range is nothing but set of Now see, domain is set of the first elements. First element is Q, first element Q, first element R. So P, Q, R. And range is set of second elements. Now the second element is 1, 5, 7, 9. This is range and domain. Very simple example. Now, if range of R, R is a relation from A to B. R, it is not real number. It is not real number. It is a relation from A to B. Equal to B. Get ekto galochona korchi. Then R is called onto relation. R is called onto relation. If range of R is proper subset of B. Now see, obviously range of R is subset of B. But when it is proper subset of B, what is proper subset? Since range of R is proper subset of B, there is an at least one element in B which has no pre-image. That implies there exists at least one element in B, at least one. There may be more than one, which has no pre-image in A. No pre-image. You just go through my second relation R2. The range of R2 was a proper subset of B because B 5 was not there. So 5 has no pre-image. Proper subset of B. Then R is called into relation. Very simple definition. If range is equal to B, so all elements of B has pre-image, then it is onto. If there is at least one element in B which has no pre-image, then it is into. Now you can check whether the two relation formed by you, whether they are into or onto. Now you check yourself. Now inverse of a relation. Relation R is equal to that AB such that A belongs to A, B belongs to B. Ordered pair BA such that AB belongs to R. R is 1P, sorry, P1, P5, that Q7, then R inverse denoted by this, R inverse is equal to koto hobe? 1P will be, P1 will be 1P.
1P.
Just reverse. 5P and 7Q. Arrow diagram of a relation. Say R be a relation defined from those two sets. P image is 1, P image is 5, Q image is 7. R image is 9. This is our one relation from A to B. Then its arrow diagram is like this. A, B. A set contains elements P, Q, R. B set has element 1, 5, 7 and 9. Now arrow diagram is P has image 1. So you have to draw an arrow from A to 1. P has image 5 also. Draw another arrow from P to 5. 9 to 7 and R to 9. This is arrow diagram. So if relation is given, you can draw the arrow diagram. Clear? Any problem?
Yes, sir.
Very easy. And if arrow diagram is given, you can write the relation. Clear?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
From yes, the sir. Relation, you can draw the arrow diagram. And if arrow diagram is given, it is very easy to write the relation. So now you have plenty of relations in your exercise book. Now draw the arrow diagram of each of them. Now we are going to discuss relations from A to A. See, both the sets are equal. Now we concentrate on relations between A to A, where A not is equal to null, obviously. From non-null set to itself. For example, let A is equal to X, Y, Z, T. Then A cross A is, A cross A is XX, XY, XZXT. YX, YY, YZ, YT. ZX, ZY, ZZ, ZT. TX, TY, TZ, and table tennis, TT. This is A cross A. This is A cross A. I considered a set A and find out A cross A, maximum four elements. Now it is your duty to take a set. Now it is your duty to take a set and form A cross A. Now form A cross A. Now see, this represents the diagonal. If we consider this as a matrix, then these are the diagonal elements of the matrix. Now I consider a relation from A to A, which contains only the diagonal elements. This relation is denoted by IA. And this is called identity relation on A or diagonal relation on. So diagonal relation is very, very tough.
No, sir.
তোমাদের কাছে যে রিলেশন গুলো আছে, এই সেট গুলো আছে, সেগুলোর এইটা বের না করেই করেছো অলরেডি, বের করতে বলেছিলাম কয়েকটা, যদি করে থাকো তার ডায়াগোনাল রিলেশন গুলো লিখে ফেলো। নাও সি, সিন্স এ কন্টেন্স ফোর এলিমেন্টস, সো আই এ অলসো কন্টেন্স ফোর এলিমেন্টস, অ্যান্ড হুইচ ফোর এলিমেন্টস, আইডেন্টিক্যাল এলিমেন্টস হুজ ইমেজ অ্যান্ড প্রি ইমেজ আর আইডেন্টিক্যাল. Image or pre-image are identical. That's why it is called identity relation. So if a set contains n element, then its identity relation will contain n elements. Not more than n, not less than n. If you omit any one of them, then it is no more an identity relation. If you omit any one of them, then it is no more identity relation, though all others are there. So it should have all the elements of the form X and Y. If you add a element XT, if you add an element other than XXYY, ZZTT, then it is again not equal to I. So to be a relation, to be IA, it should contain AA elements for all A belongs to the set A. XX, YY, ZZ, TT, all of them, and not more than that, and not less than that. So, if you are given a set A, a relation R, and you are asked to check whether this is identity or not, you have to check these two things. First, you notice which are the elements of the set. For example, if we consider a set A, O, star, Khandela. Well, its identity will contain AA, O, star, and then it is identity relation. First, you have to check whether all are there or not. Next, you have to check whether there is any element in which image and pre-image are non-identical. Tahole amake era shobai ache kina dekhte hobe. আবার এরা ছাড়া অন্য কেউ আছে কিনা ওটা দেখতে হবে। তাহলে কিভাবে আইডেন্টিটি চেক করবে বোঝা গেল? খুব কঠিন জিনিস
না স্যার।
হ্যাঁ
না স্যার,
ভিডিওটা ভিডিওটা তুমি আবার শুনবে। হ্যাঁ, নাও সি দিস ইজ এ রিলেশন আই গিভেন টু ইউ and I asked you to check whether this is a identity, this is an identity relation or not, and you just told me that it is not an identity relation because AA is there, image and image are same, but it is since of presence of this makes this relation non identity relation on A, since this element is not included on this and this A is not a member of this, though A is the same. So it is not an identity relation. To make it identity relation, you have to omit this. Okay? Now see, I am writing a relation from this. It includes XX, XY, YZ, YY, ZX, ZZ, and TT. Recording starts. Now let A is equal to set of integers. A relation on A defined by AB, a relation R, AB belongs to R if A is multiple of B. A is multiple of B. Now I ask you to check whether this relation is identity relation or reflexive relation. Whether this is identity relation or reflexive relation. First I will check whether it is identity or not. Because the checking identity and checking reflexivity has some common part. Which one is common part? You have to check that elements of the form AA, B, B, C, C exist or not for all A, B, C. Now see, it is set of integers. So it contains 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 and 0, and minus 1, minus 2, dot, 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 dot. All of that. So, this relation, if we guess that this relation is identity, so this relation should contain element of the form 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 0, 0, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, minus 3, minus 3, all elements exist or not. Now see, 1, 1 exists. Then you have to ask this question, does 1 is a multiple of 1? Answer is yes, 1 is multiple of 1. So 1, 1 exists. Does 2 is a multiple of 2? Yes, so 2, 2 exists. Does 3 is a multiple of 3? Yes, yes. This exists. Does 0 is a multiple of 0? Yes, 0 is equal to 0 into 3. Minus 1? Yes. Minus 2? Yes. So this relation contains all elements of the form AA or XX. All elements. Now, so since it contains all elements of the form AA, it may be identity, it may be reflexive. To be reflexive, it should contain say element of the form AB where A and B unequal. Now see, there is 6, 3 is there because 6 is multiple of 3. Give me few examples more. Few more examples.
3, 9.
3 is multiple of 9.
So 8, 4.
8 is multiple of 4.
15, 5.
-2 is multiple of +2. Now see, so 6, 3 belongs to R, but 6 not is equal to 3. So it is not reflect identity relation. Identity relation does not allow this type of elements. So it is reflexive. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Dago, let us consider the set of whole numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. Now we defined R from A to A by ARB. ARB means A comma B, ordered pair A comma B belongs to R. This is a parallel representation. If A divides first it was A is multiple of B. Now it is A divides B. Now see where it is reflexive or symmetric. Now check, it is reflexive or symmetric. Reflexive or identity. Now see, this relation is neither reflexive nor identity. Because ABA belongs to R for all A not equal to 0. But for A equal to 0 belongs to the set A. 0 does not divide 0. Hence, 0, 0 does not belong to R. Single element 0, 0 does not belong to R. Single element 0, 0 does not belong to R. That's why this relation is neither reflexive nor identity. Neither reflexive nor identity. Clear? So that everything is in front of your eyes. Only you need to way of looking. How to see. Only thing you need to know how to see the solution. Clear? Now see, if we consider the set as set of natural numbers, that is we omitted 0 and definition of relation remains same. In that case there, see, A belongs to R for all A belongs to A. Because every natural number is divisible by itself. Again see, 2, 6 belongs to R. Only one example is enough to prove that this relation is non-identity relation and reflexive relation. It is non-identity but reflexive. Only one example is enough. You can find out plenty of examples. 2, 6, 2, 4, 2, 8, 2, 10, 3, 6, 3, 9, 3, 12. You have enough examples ready in your mind. But you need only one to prove that this is not identity, but reflexive. Where 2 not is equal to 6. How to express it? How to express it? Yeah, 2 not is equal to 6. That implies R is reflexive, not identity. Laptop battery chole gachi. Next, consider a set. A represent the set of all straight lines on a plane. Set of all straight lines on a plane. And R on A defined by ARB, here A and B are two straight lines. A and B are two straight lines on a plane. If A and B are perpendicular to each other. Now see, no straight line is perpendicular to itself. No straight line is perpendicular to itself. So, this is non-identity. A, A type er kono element ekhane nei. Not a single element of the form A, A belongs to this set. Because there is no straight line which is perpendicular to itself. If we replace perpendicular by parallel, then what happened? We replace perpendicular by parallel. Now see, since every line is parallel to itself, every line is parallel to itself. So this is identity or reflexive? Reflexive. Since a plane jodi amra ekta straight line tari tar parallel e she ekai no. He is not the only line which is parallel to itself. On a plane, parallel to a given line, there are infinite number of lines. So infinite number of ordered pairs are there in which this line is a member. So this is reflexive, but not identity. It is reflexive, but not identity. Clear? Bojha geche?
Haan sir. Perpendicular to bujhte parlam na.
Acha, dharo this line. Is it perpendicular to itself?
Na.
Tale dharo eta naam dilam. Tale L1, L1 ki ache? R er moddhe?
Na.
Ache?
Na. Na sir.
Tale ki koro? Perpendicular to hobe na?
Touch.
Next, Daro, I'm going to set up all lines now. Line segment. First, previously considered all lines, and lines don't have any length. Now we consider set of all line segments on a plane. Now we define R by if A and B has same length. A and B have same length. Now see, every line has equal length to itself. Every line segment. Every line segment has length equal to itself. তার সমান অন্য কেউ নাও থাকতে পারে সে তো নিজে তার সমান হবে তাহলে অল এলিমেন্টস অফ দা ফর্ম এ বিলংস টু দিস নাও সি দেয়ার আর প্লেন্টি অফ লাইন্স অফ সেম লেন্থ দেয়ার আর প্লেন্টি অফ লাইন্স অফ সেম লেন্থ সো এ এ আর দ্যান এ আর নট the only elements. So there are elements of the form AB where A naught is equal to B also. So this relation is reflexive but not.
Sir, now to thakte pare.
Haan? Now mala da hoti pare. Ami ki bolechi length shaman holi tara thakbe. Dhore ekta length line segment niche AB ar ekta CD. Jodi AB length ar CD length same hoy, tale AB comma CD er moddhe dhuke gelo. Clear? এবার দেখো এখানে আমি ডিফারেন্ট ডেফিনেশনটা চেঞ্জ করে দিচ্ছি দেখো ইফ এ এন্ড বি হ্যাজ সেম এন্ড পয়েন্টস সেম এন্ড পয়েন্টস নাও সি ইট ইজ আইডেন্টিটি রিলেশন same end point দুটো end point যদি তোমাকে আমি দিই a আর b এটা যোগ করে তুমি কটা লাইন পাবে লাইন সেগমেন্ট পাবে how many line segment can you draw
একটা
joining two given points
একটা
single
একটা
তাহলে এখানে কি only a a গুলোই থাকবে a b কিছু থাকার চান্স নেই কারণ এই দুটো জয়েন করে তুমি আরেকটা কোনো লাইন পাবে না clear হ্যাঁ তো follow the definition minus know the meaning of every word and you know all these properties previously your acquired previous acquired knowledge gives you all the concept about the lines or the members of the set and use those concepts to decide whether the set is reflexive or identity clear reflexive identity clear
yes sir
yes, sir.
This yes, sir. Much today on next class Friday we'll go ahead of this thank you